Number 5.
The jointly developed Indo-Russian supersonic cruise missile, Brahmos, is all set to be the first of its kind to be integrated on a fighter aircraft for the Indian Air Force. On June 25, 2016, a modified Indian Air Force Sukhoi Su-30 MKI aircraft carried a Brahmos-A. This is the first time in the world that such a heavyweight supersonic cruise missile is being integrated on a fighter aircraft. The twin-seat multirole fighter took off from the Hindustan Aeronautics Ltd airport in Bengaluru, and conducted a 45-minute sortie with the missile attached to its underbelly. Let us now understand the different aspect of this game-changing development, and analyze why this will be a reason for major concern for both China and Pakistan.
Number 4.
In September 2010, India's newly constituted Tri-Services Strategic Forces Command submitted a proposal to the Defence Ministry for setting up two dedicated squadrons of aircraft comprising 42 Su-30 MKI air dominance fighters. The principal task of this mini-air force is to deliver nuclear weapons. The picture became clearer in October 2012 when the Cabinet Committee on Security green-lighted a program to carry out structural and software modifications on 42 Su-30 MKI, and acquire 216 air-launched Brahmos missiles. Until then, the Brahmos was for exclusive use by the Navy. In March 2015, the SFC received the first of these 42 Sukhois, which will be modified to equip the air-launched version of the supersonic Brahmos. This is the first time that the SFC, which at present depends on the Indian Air Force for delivering nuclear weapons under its command, is acquiring its own aerial assets. Individually, the Su-30 and Brahmos are powerful weapons. But when one of the world's most capable fourth-generation fighters is armed with a uniquely destructive cruise missile, together they are a dramatic force multiplier. When the Indo-Russian Brahmos is deployed on the Su-30 MKI, Indian Air Force pilots would no longer have to fly deep into heavily defended airspace to strike enemy targets. Instead, they can launch a Brahmos from far away, and turn back to safety while the missile flies on to do the destruction. The supersonic Brahmos armed with a conventional warhead can penetrate hardened fortified targets. However, if required, the missile's conventional warhead can be replaced with miniaturized tactical nukes. This gives India an excellent flexibility in terms of offensive capabilities.
Number 3.
On instructions from Air Headquarters, Sukhoi and HAL independently conducted feasibility studies. After the IF determined that HAL had evolved the simpler, most manageable design, it placed an order to HAL in January 2014 to integrate the Brahmos onto the Su-30 MKI. Brahmos is very heavy missile and integration with the fighter aircraft was met with many technical challenges, some of which are listed as follows. 1. A key task was to strengthen the Su-30 MKI airframe, particularly its underbelly weapons station. New hardpoints and structural modifications were required. 2. Since the Brahmos protrudes beyond the Su-30 MKI air intakes, it was imperative to ascertain that it did not impede the flow of air into the fighter's engines. This was achieved through computational fluid dynamics modeling. 3. New cockpit controls had to be added for pilots so that they can use it while launching the Brahmos. Developed jointly by India's Defence Research and Development Organisation and Russia's NPO Mashinostroynya, Brahmos-A is a modified variant of its basic configuration, specifically designed for air launch. It features several design refinements, which include a lighter propulsion system, weight reduction to 2,500 kg from 3,000 kg, as well as redesigned fins and nose cap. Having established through the test that the Su-30 MKI can carry the Brahmos in flight, The IF will now carry out flight testing to determine the penalty such a bulky external load imposes on flight parameters like speed and turn performance. After that, the IF will actually fire the Brahmos from the aircraft, ensuring that the missile separates from the fighter smoothly. This phase of testing will also check how accurately the Brahmos hits its target.
Number 2.
Sukhoi 30 Mki has a range of 3,000 km, which can be extended with mid-air refueling or using disposable fuel pods. Currently Brahmos has a range of 295 km. Russia is a signatory of MTCR and India was not. According to the MTCR guidelines, Russia could not help or jointly develop a missile with a non-MTCR nation, whose range is more than 300 km. This is why Brahmos' range had to be limited below 300 km. Now India has entered into the missile technology control regime, which effectively gives it a free hand in developing or importing long-range missiles from other countries. India and Russia has decided to double the range of Brahmos missile from existing 295 km to 600 km. Russian President Putin made a mention of this last year in Goa. When speaking to journalists from Russia, he said, "We have agreed to improve the Brahmos missile, which will be land, air and sea launched. We will also work to increase its range. As per most strategic experts, the range enhancement will require only minor changes in software and hardware. It is widely accepted fact that Brahmos always had the ability of much greater range. It is that, now it will be unlocked."
Number 1.
The Brahmos' maximum speed is 3,700 km per hour, literally faster than a bullet, which means it hits the target with a huge amount of kinetic energy. In tests, the Brahmos has often cut warships in half and reduced ground targets to rubbles. The Sukhoi's blistering speed will add extra launch momentum to the missile, resulting in even higher destructive power. Since the missile is very fast and is maneuverable, it will be almost impossible to intercept. Pakistan and China has no defense against Brahmos. Fact of the matter is that even United States with all its advanced technologies will find this missile very hard to intercept. The massive range of the weapon combo will hugely bolster India's strike capabilities. Brahmos integration with Sukhoi will certainly be very serious challenge to both Pakistan and China.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. Kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.